Ja. It's another eater Wally. I think it's a Wally. Let me see. No, it's a bass. Damn. About the same place. But if you saw my bobber go down, there's still a lot of depth underneath it.
Yeah,
that's a good bass. Just hand me the small one. I'll take care of it. I'll let you stay in the hole. I know you're trying to get into it. Okay, here we go. Well, I'm gonna go right and then bring him to you. Damn, he's got some legs on him. Yeah, yep, we'll come down, try it again.
God damn it!
That's a tank. That's a good one. Oh man, that's a nice bass. Woo! Oh. Caught underneath Dad's tree with a bobber set at about 10 feet.
15?
Yeah. They look a lot chunkier.
In the water?
Well, even holding them up, you're like, man. They're like, you're chunky. And then you put them down and they're like, oh, he shortened up.
Yeah.
God damn. Let me guess. Next year you're gonna come preset with two bobbers? Two bobber rods?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Instead of a makeshift bobber rod and a bobber rod.
I don't have a makeshift bobber rod.
No, what I'm saying, like, you're gonna have one rod dedicated to bobber rod.
Oh yeah.
And then the other one's gonna be, well, I'm saying, like, this year was you had a dedicated bobber rod and then you converted one, but next year you're gonna have two dedicated bobber rods.
5,000%.
You know what I'll do next year? I'll bring an ultralight, and that'll be, quote, my second bobber rod, but that'll be my crappie rod, but if I need it to be a second, put it deep, I can.
A panfish rod, two bobber rods, a walleye rod, and a jig rod, that's it.
What's your walleye rod?
My flipping stick, or my
musky
rod.
What about Senko?
That'll be my ultralight.
I guess you could do that for pan. Oh yeah, you could do that for panfish because you could do a clip bobber. Fucking Nick with some fucking brains today. I love it. I like that. That's a smart idea. Very smart idea.